Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host, Manna Mena Cheri, and these are the major news stories of Sunday, December 17, 2023. Prime Minister Narendra Modi calls for detailed investigation into Parliament security breach. Meanwhile, the Delhi police recovered fragments of broken and burned mobile phones. At least 9 lives were claimed and several injured in a blast at an explosives factory in Nagpur. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu confirmed new Qatar-mediated negotiations were underway to recover hostages held by Hamas. In Kerala, protests intensified as courts acquitted the accused in Vandiperiyar case. KPCC chief demanded CBI probe. Kerala Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan said Governor Arif Muhammad Khan provokes protesters with insensible acts. Let's get into the details. Prime Minister Narendra Modi called for a detailed investigation into last week's major security breach of Parliament, countering demands from opposition parties for a debate in the chamber on the incident. 4 days after the Parliament security was breached, the Delhi police has recovered fragments of some broken and burned mobile phones used for the crime from Rajasthan's Nagpur. Police officials said Lalit Jha and Mahesh Kumawat, who were among 6 arrested by the police in connection to the case, intentionally destroyed the mobile phones to hide technical evidence related to the case. Police arrested 6 people, filing terrorism charges against 4, after a man jumped into the lower house chamber while members were in session, shouted slogans and set off a smoke canister. A second man tried to follow him. Both were caught by lawmakers and security personnel and taken away. At least 9 workers were killed and several injured in a blast at an explosives factory in Maharashtra's Nagpur. The police officer, surnamed Salve, said, "Blast occurred around 8:30 a.m. at a factory run by Solar Industries India. The factory manufactures industrial and military explosives as well as propellants and warheads for India's defense sector," according to the Solar Industries website. Salve said, "Injured were shifted to a nearby hospital," adding that the number of casualties could increase. Salve was a part of the team that went to the site of the explosion on Sunday morning. The police are still investigating the cause of the blast, which occurred in the factory's packing area. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu appeared to confirm on Saturday that new Qatar-mediated negotiations were underway to recover hostages held by Hamas in Gaza, after a source said Israel's lead negotiator met Qatar's Prime Minister. Hamas said in a statement, "It affirms its position not to open any negotiation to exchange prisoners unless the aggression against our people stops once and for all," adding that the movement communicated this position to all mediators. The accidental killing of 3 hostages by Israeli forces has put increased pressure on Netanyahu to find a way to secure the release of those held. Meanwhile, Palestinian Health Ministry said at least 5 Palestinians were killed on Sunday in an Israeli attack on Tulkam in the occupied West Bank. 2 were shot dead by Israeli forces. Kerala has been witnessing widespread protest after court acquitted the man who raped and murdered a 6-year-old child at Churakulam in Vandiperiyar. Kerala Pradesh Congress Committee President K. Sudhakaran demanded a CBI inquiry into the case. Sudhakaran, who visited the lane house of the victim girl on Sunday morning, told her parents that if they wished, his party's legal wing, Lawyers Congress, would provide legal aid to pursue the case in the High Court. His visit comes in the wake of the special POKSO court in Kattapana on Thursday issued an order acquitting the lone accused in the case, citing want of evidence. Speaking to the media, Sudhakaran also hit out a chief minister and LDF government for brutal attack by DYFI and CEM's security men on Youth Congress and KCU activists who staged a black flag protest during the Navakerala Sadas in Alappuzha. Kerala Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan has trained guns on Governor Arif Muhammad Khan days after the latter used offensive terms against SFI activists who blocked his vehicle and waved black flags as a mark of protest. Kerala CM alleged that the governor has been provoking protesters with his insensible acts. Though he denounced the governor's act against SFI workers, he He ignored the media's questions about his gunman's brutal assault on youth Congress activists. Criticizing the governor, Pinarayi said, "The governor's acts are inviting protest. SFI is protesting against him for acting as per the commands of RSS. He has been using offensive terms against the protesters. I wonder how could a person who was in active politics call them bloody criminals? This was an insensible act. A higher official is not supposed to use such a derogatory terms." That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Manna Mena Chedi. Daily News Dose is produced by Vishnu Muralidharan with technical support from Idea Brew Studios. Follow on manorama.com for detailed updates on latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.